On to other updates for now, Indonesia's Joko Widodo has won another term as president of the world's third biggest democracy. But his rival, retired General Prabowo Subianto, has alleged widespread cheating. Indonesia's election commission was expected to announce the official results on Wednesday. But fearing unrest and street demonstrations in response to the final count, the poll panel released the final tally early with little advance notice. Some 85.6 million Indonesians cast their ballot in favor of Widodo, of about 154 million voters. Widodo and his running mate, Maruf Amin, won by a 55.5%. Their rivals, Subianto and Sandiaga Uno, claimed 44.5% of the vote. Subianto has now vowed to challenge Widodo's victory, alleging widespread voter fraud. He warned that the result could spark street protests across the world's biggest Muslim-majority nation. Subianto had lost the 2014 presidential bid to Widodo, which he later unsuccessfully challenged in court. It's not immediately clear, though, if Subianto will formally challenge Widodo's victory this time. Some 32,000 security personnel were deployed across the country, especially in capital Jakarta, including in front of the Election Commission's office. Tensions have also been high since local police said that dozens of Islamic State-linked terror suspects had been arrested. These included some who had allegedly planned to detonate bombs at political demonstrations after the election result was announced. Indonesia held its biggest ever election last month, a massive one-day polling exercise with more than 190 million registered voters and a record 245,000 candidates vying for the presidency, parliamentary seats and the local legislator positions. And the political situation in Austria continues to deteriorate. In a new development, all the ministers of the Freedom Party have resigned from office. The party had warned of a mass resignation once the Chancellor, Sebastian Kurz, asked the President to remove the Interior Minister, Herbert Kickl. The Chancellor had earlier asked Kickl, the Freedom Party's General Secretary, to take responsibility for the corruption scandal. Key ministers in the Cabinet, like the Ministers for Defence, Transport and Foreign Affairs, have also stepped down. Kerr said the scandal had damaged Austria's international reputation, the plug on his 17-month-old government. The whole crisis was triggered by a leaked video which showed the Freedom Party leader and vice chancellor, Hans Christian Strache, colluding with the Russian oligarch. Strache was seen asking for a favorable media landscape in exchange for certain favors. The scandal could not have come at a worse time, though, as the European Parliament elections are scheduled to be held from the 23rd to the 26th of this month. The resignations have created an administrative vacuum in Austria, with the snap elections only scheduled for September.